Welcome back to the Cloud and Data Science channel. Hope you are all doing well. This is continuation of the Azure Data Engineering Prep Series. In this video, we are going to see how to create Azure Function App and how to trigger that using the Blob. Please don't forget to subscribe to the channel. In today's systems, for example, in the data pipelines, we need to automate a few things. Okay, whenever we receive any new events, we need to react to that. So in order to automate that, we need Function App. Okay, so Function App is basically serverless code. Here we will write a small code, and we need not to focus on any servers or infrastructure deployment. In this Function App, whenever we receive a new event, this will be automatically triggered, and that will invoke this some other process. Okay, for example, when we receive the data from IoT streams, or whenever we place a new file on the Azure Blob storage, then we can trigger the Function App automatically. Internally, that Function App will trigger another process that can be the data processing notebook, Azure Databricks notebook. Okay, so the another advantage of this Function App is it is on demand. It provides on demand compute. So whenever there is a need or more traffic, right, then based on the load, based on the number of files, the compute will be automatically, the resources will be automatically provisioned, and those will be, the files will be processed. Those many number of Function App instances will be created, and the number of resources also will be upgraded. Okay, horizontally scalable, and it is automatically provisioned. Similarly, whenever the load reduces, then it automatically drop off those number of resources, and the number of Function App instances will be reduced. So it is based on the consumption. That is another advantage of the Function App. And we need not to deploy the server, and we need not to worry about the infrastructure. Okay. So in this video, we are going to see the lab, hands-on lab. We will create a Function App, and then we will add a simple function. And then we will create a storage account and then container, and we are going to upload a file to that Blob storage container. And finally, we are going to monitor the logs in the Function App to make sure that that Function App is triggered whenever we place a file. Okay, this is the Function App, and this is the Blob storage. Okay, we are going to upload an object, file object, then that will automatically trigger this function. This function will automatically internally trigger some other process, either it can be data processing notebook. Okay, let's go to the Azure portal. Yeah, this is the Azure portal. Now, first we will create a resource, Function App. Okay, so search for the Function App. Function App. Click on the create. Once we click on the create, then let us give the Function App name. Okay. Now there are two options to publish. We can publish as the code, or we can publish as a Docker container. We can create a Docker image and publish as the container. Runtime stacks. Let us select a .NET runtime version 3.1 and region central. Okay. Click on review. Click on hosting. In the hosting, here we have to select the storage account. So this is the storage account we will use with storage. Okay. And operating system, let us keep Windows, and plan consumption. Here consumption, basically the consumption plan type, it will allow to, based on the demand, automatically the compute will be added or dropped. So if the number of requests or number of files load is more, then the computes will be added. Similarly, if the load is reduced, then automatically the number of computes will be dropped. Okay, so that is the consumption. We need not to worry about resources, compute resources. Click on the monitoring. Here we can select enable Azure application insights, but that will be additional cost. Okay, now click on tags. Here we can create some tag. Okay, so based on the project, we can give that project name, and we will use that tag for identifying the costing for that project or billing purposes. Click on review plus create. Okay, now this is the summary. Now let us click on create. So it will, deployment is completed. Let us go to the resource. Okay, now Function App is created. We will add function to the Function App. Click on these functions. Okay, so click on add. add function to that function app. So here there is option development environment. We can either use Visual Studio or VS Code, or we can develop within this portal. So let us select within this portal. Similarly, there are various triggers, okay, to trigger that function app. HTTP trigger, this will trigger whenever there is any HTTP request is coming, okay, with some input, specified input, then automatically that will be triggered. Similarly, timer trigger, this is based on specific schedule or time. Similarly, here Azure Blob Storage trigger, a function that will be triggered whenever a blob is added to a specified container in the storage. Okay, now we are going to use this Azure Blob Storage trigger. Click on that one. Now here it populated default names, blob trigger one, and path also default name. Okay, click on create. Now this will create a function. Okay, this successfully created blob trigger one function. Now let us go to that storage account, and we will place a file to that storage account. We will open another window for the storage account. Okay, here let us go to that home and storage accounts. In the storage accounts, okay, let us refresh that one. So here we have created a storage account. Okay, so this is the storage account, right? This is the storage account. So here we will go to the containers. We will create a container. Okay, the container name, let us keep the name samples-work-items. Okay, now public access level, okay, we will keep it as private, and encryption issue we will keep it as default. Okay, no available items. Click on create. So we are creating the samples-work-items. This is the container name. Once we create a container, we will upload a file to this successfully created container. Okay, now once the container is created, so in the another window we open this blob trigger one, the function that we created. Click on code plus test. Okay, so this is used to test the trigger. That means whenever we place any new file, this is our function. Okay, it shows blob trigger function pro. This is the log whenever this is the function, run function. So it takes input blob stream, and that is the logger. Okay, whenever it receives any file on the, when we upload any file on the blob, Azure Blob Storage, it will write this statement here. We will open the logs basically. Let us open this logs. Click on the logs. It connected to the logs. Okay, now let us, it connected to the logs. Now we will go to the other window where we have created the storage container, right? So this is our container name in that storage. Let us upload a file to here. Okay, here let us upload the file here. Go and take upload the file any, okay, this one. Let us upload this one. So it is, click on the upload. Yeah, this is uploaded. Okay, now let us go and see whether it triggered the blob trigger. Yeah, it triggered the blob trigger. We are able to see executing function blob trigger one. That is our function, right? So it triggered, and it also printed blob trigger function processed blob. See, this is the blob trigger function processed blob name. What is blob name? Blob trigger processed function, and blob name is, that is the document PPT we have uploaded, Azure AG303 Azure function. Okay, so this shows that whenever we upload any file to our container in the blob storage, right, this is the document we uploaded in this container in our storage account, then that triggered this function app. Okay, and we can internally, we can call any other function, and we can write some logic to process the data here. Either we can invoke the Databricks notebook, we can we can do some other process. This is basically used to automate data pipelines, data ingestion, streaming pipeline, or batch pipeline, right? If there are any database changes, it will automatically react. Or if there is any other file placed, right, then we can communicate to the business users by sending the email, right? So I hope you are able to understand the function app basic concepts. Thanks for watching. Please don't forget to subscribe to the channel Cloud and Data Science.